Hi everyone, and welcome to this installment of our Let's Learn series. Today what we're going to be doing is spending some time talking about forms so that you can dive right into the platform and start building your first form. What we're going to do is spend some time talking about our example business. We'll discuss what forms are, what the different types of forms are, some best practices that you can use when you're building your first form, and then we'll demo into the platform to build a form together. We'll circle back into the presentation for next steps and things that you can do once you've learned your forms. Our example business is named Boone's Bandanas. It's an e-commerce business that sells different products for dogs, and it also has a nonprofit side of their business where they buy a bandana, donate a bandana, and we donate to animal shelters. We're using ActiveCampaign's tools and features to really successfully run our business. We're using automations, CRM, campaigns, forms, and specifically integrating with our Shopify store. What we'll do is we'll use some examples of forms that Boone's Bandanas has created for their business as we talk about forms today. Let's dive in. Forms are something that you can embed onto your website in order to take a site visitor, capture their information, and then turn them into an active, opted-in contact within ActiveCampaign who lives on a list. They can enter into ActiveCampaign by submitting the information that lives on forms. Once you capture that information, you can start to then put them through automations, send them campaigns, and put them through your CRM if you'd like. Forms have many different uses. They're not limited to just capturing initial information. While that's one of the main things that they do, they can also act as a form of a customer support form. Maybe on your Contact Us page, you have a support form where customers can write in at any time if they have trouble with their products, if they have questions about can they dry their bandana, or maybe they're just an interested animal shelter and they want to reach out. Maybe they're looking to schedule some kind of adoption event with you, or you have some kind of follow-up survey that you'd like to send out to people who participated in your adoption event. Maybe you want different businesses to be able to register for your event, and that's how they capture your information through forms. Whatever the uses might be, just know that forms can meet your contacts at any point in their customer journey, which we'll talk about in just a second. There are four different types of forms that you can choose from within ActiveCampaign. One and the main type of form is going to be your inline form. Your inline form not only allows you to capture name and email, but it also gives you the opportunity to ask any of the custom fields that you've created in the form. So you're able to implement any of that information in order to collect what you need from your contact. Inline forms can be embedded to any page of your website so that you can really, like I said, meet the contact where they're at in your journey. Your floating bar, your floating box, and your modal pop-up are just that. They pop up, allow you to collect information quickly and swiftly, but really only allow you to include name, email, and phone number. You're not able to get all of the information that you can because custom fields aren't an option in these forms. These three forms are actually included on the Plus plan or higher, while the inline form is included on all four plan tiers. Let's talk about some form best practices. One best practice is to keep them short and sweet. You want to be able to capture the information that's important and do it efficiently. The longer your forms are, the more likely you are to lose a contact or site visitor before they complete the form. As noted, think about where they're at in your customer journey. It's really important that you start to use forms as a way to meet the contact where they're at, whether it be through a support system, from turning them into a site visitor to a contact, or simply just capturing their information so that you can give them a call to schedule a demo. Collecting important information will allow you to keep your form short and sweet. Ask yourself what the purpose of your form is, and you'll find that you can easily mold questions around that purpose. Using a double opt-in is not required, but it's recommended. What it will allow you to do is not only establish the lines of respect with your new contact through asking them to confirm their email address, but it'll also protect you as the business from getting botted email addresses into your ActiveCampaign account. Once they submit the form, you have the option to either show them a thank you or drive them to a link. Driving them to a link is always a really good best practice because it gives you an opportunity to keep them on your website. whether you drive them to your store or to your next page in the process, or you just want them to simply learn about you on your About Us page, you're keeping them on your website. It's allowing you to not only get more information in front of them, but quite possibly drive a conversion quicker. One of the two ways in which you can cookie your contacts through site tracking is by using ActiveCampaign forms. Contacts can submit their information and they get cookied upon form submission. Once they submit this information through site tracking, you're able then to follow not only their link clicks, but the pages that they're visiting through your website, really giving you the opportunity to start to follow that customer journey and see exactly what the contact is doing. Let's go ahead. We're going to dive into the platform and we're going to build a form together so that we can see exactly how it works. Now that we're in the platform, what we want to do is start to build the pieces together to create our first form. We're going to toggle over to site, as that is the part of the toolbar in which Forms lives. All of your site-based features will live here: forms, pages, web personalization, and site tracking. But for today, we know we're focused on one topic, and that's forms. You can see here that we have quite a few forms. You probably will not have as many for your business, as you're creating forms specifically to the pages on your website that matter to you. We're going to go ahead, click Create a Form. We can title it Boone's Newsletter. And what we're going to do is use the inline form. We did talk about how floating bar, floating box, and modal are essentially pop-ups, but we want to walk through how you can create a form where you're turning your site visitors into contacts and taking an opportunity to gather some information along the way. You can see here that you have four different types of form actions. Subscribe to a list is going to be your most common, and we're going to use Boone's monthly newsletter. Any of these other three actions you can also use through automations. So what we're going to do is our main action here, subscribe to a list, and we'll press create. As our templated form gets created, start to think about the different things that you want to add into your form to make it personalized to your website. We're going to first X out of our descriptive message. We also want to X out of our full name, because what we want to do is toggle over to our standard fields and include first name and last name. This makes it much easier to start to personalize the way in which you're speaking to your contacts. Instead of saying, "Hi Tabitha Hurley," it feels much more personal to say, "Hi Tabitha." If at any time you want to make a field required, you can absolutely click on it, hover over, and check the box. You can also edit what this says. We're going to say, "Subscribe to hear from Boone." If you toggle over to My Fields, you can see that you can start to drag and drop in any of the custom field information that you're looking to collect. So we're going to start by scrolling through all of our custom fields, and we're going to drag in pet's name. So right under email address, we'll drag in pet's name. We'll drag in breed. And again, we're not looking to collect a ton of information. We just want to collect at this point what's important for us to know and act on as we're getting to know more about you and your pet. It's important for us to know what size your pet is so we can market the right products to you. And last but not least, we definitely want to know what your dog's birthday is so that we can mark that as an anniversary for us and use this date-based custom field as a start trigger in automations. Now that we've added all of our fields, if you ever wanted to come in and add any additional standard fields, you could do that. You can drag in an image at any time, a captcha, phone numbers, or any other things that are important to you. Once you're done adding all of the information to your form, you can toggle over to the Style tab and start to play around with what it looks like. Maybe you want it to match your branding, your color scheme, whatever it might be. You can absolutely play around with the colors, the button, and then if you're on the Plus Plan or higher, you can turn off this Marketing by ActiveCampaign branding right here. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to toggle over to Options. You can see here that, as we talked about, you have two options for when the contact submits their form: Show Thank You, which just gives you a thank you for signing up page, or directing them to a URL. What we want to do is direct them to boonsbandanas.com/shop. If they're interested in our products, this is going to give us a good opportunity to make that conversion right away. so we want to get our products right in front of them as soon as we can. Subscribing them to a list is our form action, and as we discussed, our opt-in options live right here. You can toggle it off if you'd like, but again, it's not required, recommended. We want to switch our address to make sure that it matches our business address, and if at any point in time you want to edit your opt-in email, you can absolutely do that by clicking edit. This will be the email that your contact gets once they submit their form. Until they click on the Confirm My Subscription button right here, they will be an unconfirmed contact. They will not be a confirmed active contact that lives on a list for you to start marketing to. So make sure that when you have your double opt-in turned in, you are aware that they must confirm their subscription before being subscribed to your emails. You can edit that email in any way that you'd like and then press done once you're finished. Now that you're done with your form, you can go ahead and press integrate. You have several different options for integrating your form. Your simple embed code is going to be your most common option for embedding your form onto your website. Not only is it a much shorter code, but it also allows you to make changes to your form in ActiveCampaign and have those changes reflect immediately live on the website. Your full embed code is if you wanted to custom CSS, do any custom fonts, or change anything that you'd like specifically within the form. The link to your form is super important because it allows you to put your form other places than your website. It gives you an opportunity to copy and paste it wherever you'd like, get your form in front of as many people as you want, and take an opportunity to start collecting emails other places besides just your website. For Boone's Bandanas, our link in bio is actually this exact link to our form. Because just because you're an Instagram follower doesn't mean that you're an opted in contact. So we want to make sure that we're trying to make that conversion as quickly and as easily as possible. Your WordPress plugin lives right here and you can download it right from this page, as does your Facebook information. So once you're done embedding your form, you can simply save and exit, and now you've completed your forms. Let's talk about some next steps that you can do as you've completed building your first form. Sign up for our office hours. My teammate Shiv hosts office hours 3 times a week, and it gives you an opportunity to join an open forum where you can simply ask questions that are specific to forms, lists, tags, automations, integrations, campaigns, or any other topics within ActiveCampaign that you have questions on. Our community gives you an opportunity to speak with customers just like yourselves and see exactly what other people are doing within their accounts. It also gives you insider information into events and webinars that we're hosting so that you can see everything that's going on with ActiveCampaign. If you've stumbled upon this video, you may be watching it on YouTube, and we encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel to watch more videos just like this that are part of our Let's Learn series. Otherwise, we thank you so much for attending, and we hope that you learned lots. Let's go ahead and learn our next topic together. Happy learning!